headquarters for the Genzyme Corporation aspires to be a symbol for progress and identity for the company, its employees, and visitors. This new corporate headquarters is located on a former brownfield site and is part of a new development that includes other dynamic research institutions. The building accommodates about 920 individual workplaces and associated public areas on a gross floor area of 280,000 square feet.
Went to work and came back in front of five architectural critics, and they declined myself and others, and presented their case. And the first four presented beautiful buildings, beautiful glass buildings, and with beautiful models. Unbelievable how beautiful these things can look, statues, sculptures. And but didn't quite make the connection. You really needed to think of a lot of special stuff. And then the fifth architect came in empty-handed, nothing, no building. And he said, let me just talk to you about what I think a building would look like. And he talked to us about a building from the inside out.
The design process strove to develop a building from the inside out, focusing on the individual working environment as the key to the overall complex structure of the building. First identified in the initial architectural competition, this strategy guided the highly integrated and widely encompassing design process. The building's development demanded exchange between the architect-led design team and various client advocates for both the base building and tenant improvement phases. The creative cycle became a mutual learning experience and was critical to the realization of an environmentally friendly, highly communicative, and individual signature building.
In this building, the atrium is the family space, the entry hall, but maybe also the inner sanctum of the building. Three elements of this atrium are very important. The gardens, you see them situated on the various levels of the atrium. And then there is the daylight. Computer-driven mirrors constantly follow the sun and mirror down the daylight in the depth of this atrium.
The building envelope is optimized for Boston's harsh climate. High-performance glass and the strategic employment of double facades help to insulate the building, while sunscreens and large glass areas optimize interior light levels. The varying sizes and locations of these components create a dynamic envelope that interacts spatially with the building's interior. Internally, a climatic oasis has been created, an atrium flooded with daylight. Bifurcating like a tree over its 12-story height, its branches and twigs reach from the center of the building to the facade, creating a variety of distinct spatial experiences.
Genzyme is a life sciences company. What we do is innovate, discover, coming up with new standards of care for untreatable diseases. And so to find a way to pull together 1,000 people, almost 1,000 people, in a building that would be supported to that purpose, would be consistent to that purpose, was a very important objective for me.
The atrium links the various areas of the building vertically and horizontally. Open stairs at the perimeter of the atrium provide connections, places and paths through the gardens and around the atrium. They are part of a boulevard, which starts amid the trees and water on the ground floor and proceeds upwards, creating a meandering path of social interaction throughout the building. Along this vertical boulevard lie neighborhoods with open workstations and private offices with operable windows. Redirectional blinds throw natural light deep into the building, illuminating workstations and interior spaces. A sunlight redirection system with heliostats and fixed mirrors further enhances daylighting of the atrium space. This light is then further dispersed into the interior of the building through light extenders, sparkling chandeliers, and a reflective light wall. The Genzyme building strives to achieve the highest LEED green building rating possible, platinum.
So come back 1 year from now, and let's talk again and see whether the effect of the building is as Stefan Benes and myself have hoped. I think it will be, and I also do believe that the example that this building sets with this environment in Cambridge and Massachusetts, Eastern, part of the United States, maybe even nationally, will be followed by others in the future.